There appears to be a serious disconnect here. Over the last three months or so, we've had extensive conversations about systemic planning, needs analysis. We've talked about a $50 million budget available for schools to utilize to be able to retrofit successfully in a from a pre-COVID environment to a post-COVID environment. And of course, I'm not even talking about a school system like Providence, which is a challenge. But in this case, I'm talking about a tweet that went out from the Bristol Warren chapter of the NEA this morning, which cited over 60 systemic, fairly serious, if you will, COVID code violations of the schools. We're talking about absence of nurses, inability to have proper box fans, lack of ventilation, closed door, on and on and on and on. So is this a failure, for example, in this case of Bristol Warren Superintendent Jonathan Bryce to successfully adapt to the what's been made available by the state, or is this just a hopeless lack of communication between districts and RIDE?
So I will answer that, and then I'll let the commissioner answer it. I haven't seen the tweet to which you refer, but let me say this. Districts have had 5 months to prepare. We have provided to them over that 5 month period guidelines, support, funds, help, National Guard's help, experts, Department of Health, et cetera. And we've been in a back and forth with them. And by and large, they are all doing a pretty good job. I mean, you do have districts like Warwick who said, we're not going to try, and other places who just threw in the towel. But mostly, they're trying. So I don't think it is a failure. If they don't have something that is currently adequate, then it needs to be fixed. You know, I don't know exactly what school it is, et cetera. We went through, every school has to have an isolation room. There's certain metrics they're trying to follow with respect to airflow and amount of times that the air is turned over in a particular room in a particular hour, et cetera. So that's what they ought to have. By the way, teachers deserve that. Parents deserve that. Kids deserve that. If they don't have that, they need to become in compliance. Want to add anything?
So this is the first I'm hearing about it, but I like to get my news in other places other than social media, so I will go back to the superintendent. And the other piece that I think is really important is that they're still working on certain rooms where they don't have kids there yet. Remember, they have a phased start. So yesterday I was at Portsmouth. They have the little kids, the kindergartners and the first graders there. They were installing HEPA filters while I was there in the upper classes where their kids have not come in yet. So there's a phased approach. So I think we have to get all the details before we make assumptions or we listen to tweets. But from my point of view, I have not seen that. But I will circle back with the superintendent and provide any support that he may need. But he has not reached out.
Well, just finally, in closing, this is a 60-point text directly from the Bristol Warren NEA. So this is not social media hearsay. And some of the issues where, for example, you don't have a nurse at one of the schools is beyond troubling. It's can be catastrophic. So when you see that type of divide, in closing, parents at this point are looking for accountability. Parents are screaming for, okay, what is the truth here? And again, there's two stories. Where can parents go to get the truth?
Well, there aren't two stories, right? So the superintendent should put out there what there is. There aren't two stories. And I think we have to look at the sources, right? I think we have to look at what information needs to be put out there. I am telling you that as soon as I get off the stage, I will call the superintendent and I will get the information, all right? And I will make sure that everybody has the information. And if there's something that needs to be changed and corrected, we will work with the superintendent to ensure that it is where it should be.
Governor.